So for all you PC users, here are your tutorials on editing. So after looking at some editing softwares like Movavi, Filmora, and DaVinci Resolve, we have picked Wondershare's Filmora X. So once you open up your Filmora, this is what you'll be met with. Don't worry if it doesn't look like this and it's lighter. This will just be a difference in your settings, and I'll show you where to find that. So first off, you're going to want to pick your aspect ratio. So 16:9 is the standard video, so we'd recommend keeping it in this. If you're doing something for Instagram or a story, then you've got your 1:1 for Instagram and 9:16 for a portrait video. You also have a few others like 4:3 and 21:9, but we're gonna stick with 16:9. We're gonna open a new project. So now we are met with our workspace and we can adjust all of these to get the preview size as big as possible or to adjust height of the timeline and also just to change the amount of space these folders have for if we want some really long named folders. Now, if yours does not look like this, then yours is probably in light mode. Personally, I prefer dark mode, but the way you change that is you just go up into your system preferences, and then you can see straight away in general is your appearance. So you can have it as system default. So if you've got your PC, it's set as a light mode or a dark mode, this will automatically adjust to it. You can have it in light mode, or you can have it on dark mode. While we're in the preferences, we're just going to quickly look at the editing ones. So these are just your default durations. So when you drag a photo in, it's going to last for 5 seconds. You can change these around if you want to have these specifically come up for this amount of time. You can also change them to frames as opposed to seconds, and you can edit how long these stay in. Personally, I'm just going to leave mine with the default. We're going to then look in save. And we want to make sure this is ticked so it's automatically backing up every 5 minutes. I wouldn't recommend putting this much higher. You can bring it lower if you want. This is just to make sure that if you close it or it crashes or just something happens, that it is safe. We're now going to go into performance and we are going to turn on the background render and we're going to leave it at the default of 5 seconds. Again, this is up to you if you want to turn this up or down. Personally, I like working with a proxy file. I just think it handles a lot smoother. So I change mine to automatically make one if it's above 1280 by 720, which most of our videos will be. You can then set where you want the proxy to be made, but we're just going to leave these as the default proxy folder. We're also going to change it to automatically delete a proxy when closing a project file. This may mean that it'll take longer to load up all our proxy files, but this will also mean that we're not keeping all our files on here and just having more files on our computer and taking up storage. If you don't have this automatically delete on, you can clean this and take out all the proxy files that you have. But we'll talk more about proxy files in a later video. So that's it for our preferences. And now we just have our workspace. I'd recommend just getting this to the size that you like it and making sure that everything is where you want it to be. Okay, so that's it for the basics of your preferences and basically just some things that you want to set up. Okay, so thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it and subscribe and check out the rest of the videos in this playlist where we'll teach you a bit more about Filmora X.